I'm Malik Muhammad, owner of Malik Books, here in the Baldwin Hills Crenshaw Plaza and also Fox Hills Mall. We're located in Los Angeles and we want to invite you in. Come on in.
Since you first opened Malik's Books, what inspired you to open the bookstore?
I get that question all the time, and my answer is simple. I wanted to affect the community because books changed my life, and I want to help change the community life. You know, one of the things that I always say also is that I graduated from USC. I had a degree from college, but I did not have a knowledge of self. And that was my inspiration, because what books did for me, I wanted to do for the community.
Now, being a staple in Los Angeles for over 30 years, I know you've had many customers, not only from the Los Angeles, California area, but also all over the world. What has been the reception that you've received from the many customers that have visited your store and bought books, and I'm sure they've become long-term customers?
Without them, there is no Malik's. We exist because of you. When people come in this store, I can fuel on that energy all day long. Why? Because they have cried, they caught the Holy Ghost. They told us, they thank us for being in here. I'm just overwhelmingly appreciative of the fact that they, instead of walking by, they came in. So I'm very grateful. But they reward us with their presence, and they are excited that we are here and that we exist. And they thank us all the time. But I'm like, hey, I need to thank you, because without you, Malik Books don't exist.
Now, you spoke about your education, and everybody that has a love for books, they always have that one book that really triggered them probably very early in life. What book was that for you that just, you know, captivated your mind and made you want to read more and just captivated you?
The book that inspired me to become me, the Malik today, was The Message to the Black Man. It's a radical book. But the reality is this. The book is simple, it's unapologetic, and it's just simply put, do for self or suffer the consequences. That's the real message in that book. You don't have to get nothing else out of there, but that underlying message, do for self or suffer the consequences. And that's what woke me up, and that's what made me become an entrepreneur, and that's what drove me for me to have passion today is that I want to see a universal change in our communities. I want more for us as black people in our communities. More together. Unity is more powerful than an atomic bomb. So I exist because of the conditions of our community. And that book just says simply to me, do for self or suffer the consequences.
Now you have books from authors all over the world. What is the process for an established author, an aspiring author, to get their books in your store?
Well, we have an intake process where we ask the author to present a book and tell us a little bit about the book, because I can't read all these books, so I need to, you know, I need some information, an outline on the book. And we in our intake process is simply to make sure it meets our criteria, which is not that vigorous, but we want to make sure it's not a pamphlet. We want to make sure that it at least is a book that is marketable and that it has a name, the title that is written on the spine of the book, because we got a lot of books in Malik Books and we fighting for shelves. So sometimes we have to turn a book to the side. And if you don't have a name on the side, the spine, then it's kind of hard to do product placement. So we do have a criteria. You submit the book to Malik and we determine whether or not, because we love our authors. Why? Because Malik Books give voice to the voiceless. You know, we exist because we didn't have a voice in a lot of these stores. And then when we show them that we have a market and that black people read, all of a sudden they want to carry our books. And then they want to price us out of the market. But we never going to allow them to do that, because Malik Books, the African American Independent Bookstore, where we specialize in African American books and books of diversity, we have gifts, and we have, especially here at Malik's as well, which is children books, because they are 100% of our future.
One of the other things about your two locations is that in addition to the books, you have a beautiful wall of art of various people from Black history, various aspects of Black history. How do you do your placement with the art?
You know, much of what we have at Malik Books is an impulse. It's a feeling. It draws, you know, whether it's a book, whether it's a gift, whether it's art, I have to feel it. And it has to fit the ambiance and the spirit of Malik's. And I kind of draw on that because, you know, everything can't be explained in words. Some things are just a feeling and a presence and a spirit. And so I draw from that. That's all. I draw from that energy. I draw from that spirit. And I think that, you know, that could be a guide for us oftentimes in the midst of darkness.
Now, over the years, I'm quite sure that you've had various book signings from people all over. What are some of your most memorable book signings that you've had at your locations?
Well, we've hosted a number of authors over the years, just to draw memories from a few. Eric Jerome Dickey, our beloved brother, who just made a transition. May you rest in peace. We have his books right here. We want to continue to support one of our beloved who made his transition. Having a book signing with him, I mean, a lot of present day authors were inspired by Eric Jerome Dickey and a lot of his writings. Also hosted over the years seminars and debates. Over the years, I used to do a debate series back years ago. It was called The Great Debate. And so I get two opposing views and I let them, and I draw up a platform so that they can have a robust discussion and oftentimes argument on a particular viewpoint. There's two extremes. The Great Debate Series was an iconic event here in Los Angeles that drew thousands of people.
So how has the power of the internet since your inception, you know, 1989, was the internet like it is now? How has that helped you reach the world and getting people to shop and know more about Malik Books?
The internet has made Malik Books worldwide now. As a result of the pandemic, a lot of people are now shopping online, and it gave us an opportunity to be heard and known for the first time. So I'm very appreciative of all those who have purchased from Malik Books all over the United States and all over the world. As a result, our online business has become robust and very important and critical aspect of Malik Books and our mission and journey. As a result, you know, we've been able to make more networking connections with publishers as well as authors. The online business, brother, going forward is the future. And Malik Books want to be part of that future. We can't be everywhere at all times, but the internet gives us the ability to service people all over the world.
As a black entrepreneur, black business owner, what wisdom was given to you that you would like to share with everybody that's aspiring to own a business? They may own a business and they may be just starting up. What is the best piece of advice that you received that you would like to share with them?
I got two pieces, because they kind of work hand in hand. Number one, don't let money stop you from opening your business. Sometimes just knowing someone could be the resource to launch your business. We oftentimes don't want to move forward because we say we don't have money. And I used to think like that. But it was through friendships and all walks of life how I opened up Malik Books. Because they underwrote me and gave me a credit line. And as a result, I was able to expand and grow. So don't let money stop you from believing that just because you don't have this money that you can't bring. Now, I know you need money to do certain things, but you can get it in different ways. Don't always think you got to go to a bank and borrow money to make that happen. You know, another point that I like to say, which I think holds all of us back at some degree, fear. You know, fear, you have to challenge through fear, because the only way to do business is to do business. You can't let fear stop you from engaging in business. So the best way, because you're going to make mistakes, everything ain't going to be perfect, you're going to have growing pains, and what you got to do is learn from it and grow from it. So don't let the fear stop you or procrastinate because you have fear. Just got to go do it. You got to be in the game to be in the game. Being on the sideline, so you can talk about business or be about business. So my 2 points, brother, is simply, brother, is that don't let money stop you and don't let fear stop you. Because oftentimes, those are the two biggest game stoppers that why people don't go into business. And we need to go into business because we 2 million businesses short in our communities all over America. Because we seem to think going to college and getting a degree is the only avenue to be successful. Well, there's more than one way to be successful. Opening a business and being an entrepreneur. There's not enough jobs in America to sustain us. So stop thinking that the only way is to go to school and get a degree and go work for a corporation. Make your own corporation. Go in business for yourself. You can be an electrician, plumber. You can own a department store, clothing store, a restaurant, and get a tech company. You can create. So go in business for yourself, because we 2 million jobs short all over this country as a result of us thinking in the last 50 years that the only way to be successful is to get a degree and work for corporate America. So now we got all these youth out here with no opportunities, because a lot of people got degrees and a lot of them don't have a job. Malik Books has 2 locations to serve you, in the Baldwin Hills Crenshaw Plaza and the Fox Hills Mall. We also have a website, malikbooks.com, and an Instagram. Follow us, and that's Malik Books on Instagram.
Although Malik Books is primarily a diverse and cultural bookstore, we're more than just a bookstore. Malik Books has partnered with different organizations and have organized and promoted book drives, giving away books to kids in the underserved communities of Los Angeles. Malik Books in the last 5 years has helped the Crusader Praise Scott Scholarship Fund give away 18 scholarships in the last 5 years to incoming freshmen entering college. We serve because children are 100% of our future.